A long time ago, when the Greeks had money and dressed in sheets, it was thought that thinking came from a kind of internal self, what the Romans later called the homunculus, the little man. No one suspected that thinking happened in the brain. It was just so dull. Instead, it was the more exciting internal organs, like the heart, the liver and the spleen, that were marked out as the essential parts of thought, reason and emotion. Complete nonsense, of course, but progress was slow because for a long time, dissection was banned by the church. Eventually, however, it was noticed that the eyes are connected to the dull wobbly part inside our heads and that in turn it was connected to the rest of the body via a stringy network of wiry structures, the nervous system. By the 18th century, an Italian called Luigi Galvani had discovered that the wiry bits carried electricity, which operated muscles. This he endlessly demonstrated by attaching frog's legs to a battery. It was now clear that the brain actually has an important job to do, controlling the body with electricity. Gradually, physicians started paying more attention to the brain. They noticed that injuries to specific parts of it would affect specific abilities. Injuries changed the ability to smell, hear, or speak. Accidents revealed a lot about how the brain worked. But well-meaning surgeons showed even more. A severely epileptic American was treated by such a surgeon who scooped out part of his brain called the hippocampus. The fit stopped, but so did the patient's ability to form new memories. The brain, it turned out, is responsible for memory. All of a sudden, scientists were all over the brain, probing it, recording electrical activity. One of them, Wilder Penfield, made a map of the brain by poking about in the brains of conscious patients. He produced the sensory homunculus, an image of how the brain senses the body. It was also discovered that our brain is responsible for us being conscious or unconscious, and that it's responsible for us being aware of being conscious, or consciousness. It was also found that the way the brain works can be altered using drugs, and that there's another part of our brain that's running the show, our subconscious. And that means that our brain knows what we're going to do before we do. It's almost as though we're being controlled by another version of ourselves. Traditionally, the brain is compared to the most impressive technology available. In the past, it's been a kind of complicated steam engine, an electronic telephone exchange, and a microprocessor. Today, the brain is presented as being a bit like the internet. Tomorrow, who knows? The fact is, no one actually knows exactly how the brain works, but at least we now know where to look.